back for our third week of our at-home science experiments. We hope you've been enjoying them so far. I know I've had so much fun making them, and I love when I get to see you guys try them out for yourselves. So whenever you are able to, please send in a video of you guys trying them out. I will have an email for you guys to reference at the end if you're willing to do that for us, but we would love to see them. So for today, we're going to be learning all about solids, liquids, and gases by creating a self-inflating balloon. So for this, you're going to need an empty plastic water bottle or pop bottle, anything of that sort, a balloon, a spoon, baking soda, vinegar, and then a funnel. All right, everyone, we are ready to get started on our experiment. So as you can see, I have my solid here, which is the baking soda. I have my liquid, which is the vinegar. I have my spoon to scoop my baking soda, I have my balloon ready, and I also have a funnel. And so I've already put my liquid, which is the vinegar, into my plastic bottle. And for this, I used about 1/4 cup, but it doesn't have to be exact. Just kind of try to estimate it to have it fill just around the same spot that I have. And then for this, vinegar can burn your eyes, so you need to be very careful. I would suggest having a grown-up pour the vinegar in for you, and make sure everyone is washing their hands afterwards. Okay, now we are ready to put our baking soda inside of our balloon. So what I've done is put the balloon on the bottom of the funnel, and you just wanna make sure it's over the neck of the balloon so the baking soda can fall right into the main part of it. So I'm gonna take my spoon. This is about a teaspoon, but it doesn't have to be perfect. And just scoop that right into the funnel and shake that down into the balloon. And so go ahead and pause and do this for yourself. Now that we have our baking soda inside of our balloon, you can go ahead and do what I did here and secure the balloon to the top of the water bottle. But be careful as you are doing this because you want to make sure none of the baking soda goes into the water bottle just yet. You see how I have my baking soda hanging off to the side here. So right now it's just waiting to go inside. So be careful when you are securing this. Go ahead and pause and do this. Now that your balloon is secured just like mine, it is time to do the fun part. So what you're gonna do is lift up this part of the balloon so that the baking soda drops inside of the water bottle. So go ahead and pause and do this and observe what happens. So what you will see is that the baking soda and vinegar combine to make a gas called CO2, which inflates the balloon without you having to do any work for yourself. Now it's time to talk about science. Vinegar, our liquid, is an acid, and baking soda, which was our solid, is a base. When they combine, the product they create is CO2, or carbon dioxide gas. The CO2 gas then inflates the balloon because it has nowhere else to go. So because the vinegar and baking soda combine to make a carbon dioxide gas, which is also a greenhouse gas, we thought the perfect book to pair with this experiment would be The Wump World by Bill Peet. This book relates perfectly to Earth Day, and that was just on the 22nd of April. So we just experienced it, and it's perfect to talk about the cleanliness of the world, and even how the coronavirus has been affecting that cleanliness. So although it's not good for people, a lot of major cities have been seeing a decrease in pollution like greenhouse gases, like CO2. So this is a perfect book to read if you are able to. So go ahead and enjoy that and check back in next week for our next experiment.